You get to this spiral, you get more and more stressed and depressed and stressed and depressed, and like, oh, look, what's wrong with that? And at the end, it's really counterproductive. So your own brain is sort of your enemy there. So my advice was basically just to try and control your mood and your approach. So be sort of scientific. You guys are all smart, right? You're all cool programmers and you can solve problems and you're an analytical and so on.
But use those skills not just to write programs or to play games or something like that. Use those skills to manage your life and program your life. So I did some investigations on myself and discovered when I did a bit of exercise, like a walk, it cheered me up. And it turns out that's often the case. If you do a bit of exercise, it cheers you up. And it sort of recharged my mind. So often if I'm stressed and busy, I stop exercising and going for walks and things because I'm so busy, and that's counterproductive. I go into a spiral. Another thing is get enough sleep. Because if you're overloaded and stressed, you tend to work even harder and you get less sleep. And actually, that's a destructive spiral too. So sort of control your mood. And the other thing is try and stay cheery. And I can give you a little anecdote about this. Years ago, I was running late for something through my own overcommitting and optimism about how long it would take me to do things. I arrived at the airport 20 seconds before the plane was going to lift off or something ridiculous like that. I probably arrived just in time, but you walk through the doors and suddenly there's this really depressing line. And you think, I'm going to make it if there's no one else there. Oh, and there's a million people in line. I was really depressed and I was standing in line and the clock's ticking closer to that time where I lose my airfare. And I'm slowly moving through the line. And in front of me are two like surfy guys, and just with their surfboards and hey, dude, and just standing there in shorts and relaxing. And then a couple of other surfy guys wandered up to them and started chatting to them and they're talking. And the other guys sort of had bags with them and they started itching up closer. And I'm thinking, these guys are going to jump in the queue ahead of me. And they're going to let their friends join the queue ahead of me. There's going to be two more people ahead of me. And they're trying to do it subtly and surreptitiously. And they are going to make me miss my plane. And I said, you guys weren't thinking of pushing in, were you? In my scariest voice. And they looked completely stunned. They looked at me and they had this jaw drop. And you could see, suddenly I saw, no, they weren't at all. They were just saying hi to their friends. And they were completely laid back and relaxed. And I said, oh, man, you look really stressed, they said to me. Are you worried? Are you going to be late? Here, come in front of us. And there were these really nice people, and suddenly I felt so ashamed. I thought, wow, here I was all stressed and worried and I was projecting it onto everyone else. And I thought, I want to be like them. This sort of laid back, mellow, you know, da-na, da-na. It's very hard to achieve. But I think that's the secret to happiness. So no matter, I think the mark of a person is not how they behave when everything's going well, because that never happens. It's how you behave when things are going badly. And when all around you is chaos and people are letting you down and bad things are happening, do you get all tense and angry with everyone? And or do you just sort of just think, oh, okay, and just sort of try and cope with it and smile and still make jokes and laugh? And that's how I want to be. I think that's the way of solving problems. So that was my lame advice, was to just not get too stressed. And if you're feeling overwhelmed, well, then don't let it get you overwhelmed. Be happy, be relaxed. And my time management tip is this. I've discovered that there's too much to do in life and there's not enough time. So it's not a matter of moving things around and they'll fit. It's like, how do you fit four elephants in a mini miner? Do you know that joke? How do you fit four? Do you know the answer to that? How do you fit four elephants in a mini miner? It was a joke when I was a little boy. Well, you put two in the front and two in the back. But it's not a matter of how you arrange the stuff in your life. There's actually too much stuff to fit in your life is the problem. So the trick is to suddenly realize, and this is very relaxing, that, oh, well, I'm not going to do it all then. Ah, some stuff I'm not going to do. And the trick is, which stuff don't you do?
Project.
The project. Man, I can't believe you even started the project. Yeah. No, what don't you do? You're going to shed some stuff. What are you going to shed?
Sleep.
No. That path doesn't, it's not a productive path to take that path. Don't shed sleep. Shh, shh. The trick is, guys, you got to work out what the most important things are and what the least important things are. And then you got to make sure you do the important stuff. And it doesn't matter so much about the stuff that's not important. But I think it's a human condition that we always do the stuff that's the urgent stuff. So given a list of stuff to do, you'll probably do the thing that's most urgent first. But actually, I think that's a trap, because often the most urgent things are fairly trivial things, it's not important. Don't worry about how urgent it is, do the most important thing. If you've got time to do everything, important things and non-important things, then sure, do the urgent ones first. But often you'll find the urgent things are just time sucks. So just go, mañana. So get your surfboard out and think, I'm not going to do that. So that's coping. And the last thing I've got to say is, in essence, this whole course, hopefully, is teaching you to be, or encouraging you to be analytical and scientific and have design and all these sort of engineering geeky skills. But more important than all of that stuff, and you guys are all good at that stuff, more important than all that stuff is the stuff that maybe you're not so good at. And can I encourage you to try and find happiness and love and romance and friendship? Because if you get that stuff sorted, then everything's cool. And if that stuff's not right, then it's very easy to get depressed and stressed, and then everything goes cool, bad. And so I have a story to tell you about that. And this story, I remembered yesterday when we did Fermat's Little Theorem. And Fermat's Little Theorem was that a to the p mod p minus 1 was always 1, except, you know, a has to be coprime with p. And looking at that equation, you might have noticed I was blinking back some tears when I saw that, because that reminded me of when I was in primary school. And the teacher said, we're going on an excursion now, and we're going to divide in little groups and do some scientific explanation, and we're going to keep a journal, and everyone's going to write an entry in the wiki. And everyone just get together with your friends and form little groups of three. And I had lots of friends at that school. But you know what happened? It's like every kid's nightmare. What do you think happened? I was left over. Yeah, everyone. The class had like one more than the multiple of three people in it, and I was left. Because although I had lots of friends, they just somehow had better friends with other people. And I was really sad. And this, so whenever I see mod something equals one, it makes me think about that poor person left over when it doesn't divide into it. And it's worse than that. Because we then had another excursion, and you had to divide into pairs. And I just was so sure it wasn't going to happen, so straight away I ran up to one guy and said, let's be together. And he said, oh, I already promised someone, my imaginary friend, that I'd be with him, sorry. And I turned around, and it was too late, everyone else, and I was so desperate that this time I wasn't going to be left alone, and I was alone again. Now, it's crazy because the number of people in the class, X, mod 3, was congruent to 1. And the number of people in the class X mod 3 mod 2 was also congruent to 1. And it turns out the Chinese knew this ages ago, that there's all these unpleasant consequences that flow from this too, because that also means that X mod 3 times 2, X mod 6, will also be congruent to 1. So, you know, what's the bet that the teacher's next plan was to have an excursion with 6 people groups in it? So that made me think of that. It's very sad. I'm going to put that up so I don't have to see it, and it's okay. It's just no good anymore since you went.